Okay, so in this session, actually, we are going to see the again more advanced interfacing. In this program, in the loop function, we are reading the analog sensor value which is connected to A0, and that value we are putting into the pot val variable. Now we know that analog read function will give the minimum value as 0, maximum value as 1023. So pot value is range start from 0 to 1023 only. We are again printing that value for our purpose only. But now what we need to control the LED brightness with that pot. So previously we have used that function, analog write function. Okay, analog write function, which is taking the two argument. First one is what is the pin number? The pin number should be the PWM pin. And the second argument should be what is the analog value that you want to write. But that value, second value, should be in the range of 0 to 255. Okay, so here there is a problem. We have the value which is having the range 0 to 1023, but we want to convert that value to the another range to 0 to 255. Okay, so in a Arduino, actually there is one function is there, map function. This map function will convert the one range value to another range. One range should it's converted into another range. So which variable is the input variable? Pot value is the input variable. What is the range, minimum range and the maximum range, maximum value of that pot val we are putting as a second and third argument. Fourth and fifth argument is what is the target range, that is 0 to 1023 is converting to 0 to 255. So map function will do for us. And now we are getting the new variable, val variable, which is the conversion of the pot val. Okay, which is the conversion value of the pot val. Firstly, pot val is 0 to 1023, but val is now only having the value from 0 to 255. Similarly, if you want to do manually, then just I can do pot val divided by 4. Okay, pot val divided by 4, I'll also do the same task. Okay, so val value is there. Val value is there. Now we want to write that value into the analog write. Suppose pot val is having the maximum value 1023. So it is converted into the 255. So val it's contained 255. So analog write LED comma val. So full brightness LED you can get there. Okay. So similarly, you can change the LED brightness with the pot. So this is the result. So here I'm changing the pot val. Potentiometer shaft. Accordingly, that brightness of that LED will change there. Yes. Okay. The next one is this type of assignment again you can do. LED control on sensor analog sensor value. So here we are reading the pot value by using analog read function, and depending on the value of the pot val, we are making the LED on or off. Okay, suppose the threshold value of that sensor is there. So our analog sensor is there and the threshold value is 500. If the threshold, if your pot val goes above 500, then alert should be generated. Now I'm using that indication, this visual indication, LED. So digital write LED comma high will make that LED high when the pot val is greater than or equal to 500. And it will also print on a serial, that is alert beyond threshold value. Otherwise, if it is low, then it will print a LED. It will print safe below threshold value and the LED remains low there. This is a simple project implementation where instead of pot, you can use any analog sensor, just like your pressure sensor, temperature sensor, and you can use this threshold value. Just need to compare this threshold value, and depending on that, you need to perform some action there. So this type of again assignment you can give to your students. Now the next one is your LED blinking rate control. Okay, so LED blinking rate control. So it means that here, depending on the value of that pot, now it starts from 0 to 1023. So that pot valve I'm using to generate a delay. So if you change the that shaft of your potentiometer, then what happened? The pot valve is increasing or decreasing. So if the pot valve is increasing, the delay is increasing. If the pot valve is decreasing, the delay is decreasing. Okay. So LED blinking rate control also we can achieve by using this pot potentiometer. So this is the simulation of that assignment. You can see a pot valve is now 920. If it is 920, then blinking rate is high. So first, it is very small, then blinking rate is high. Okay, so this type of again programs you can also implement to have more hands-on on your Arduino. Okay, now the next sensor, that is analog sensor, is the LDR, that is a light dependent resistor. Generally, this is a very useful resistor or the sensor where we want to detect the light. Okay, so this is a simple type of resistor, you can say that, but it is a variable resistor. Okay, as your pot value, the pot resistance can be varied by moving its shaft, but here the resistance of the LDR can be varied by just throwing one light on it. If you put the light on the LDR, then the resistance become low. And if you are if there is a darkness is there, then the resistance is high. Okay, so dark resistor is always high, and when there is a light intensity, according to the light intensity, your resistance becomes low there. Okay, so resistance decreases when the light increases. Okay, so it is a reciprocal of the light. Okay, so it can be used to detect the light and change the operation of the circuit dependent upon the light levels. They can describe by a variety of names, from light dependent resistor, LDR, or the photoresistor. Photoresistor is also the common name being used, or even a photocell or photoconductor. Now application is the photographic application is the photographic light meters, fire or smoke alarm, as well as the burglar alarm. And they also find uses of lightning control for the street lamp. Okay, so there is smart lightning light is there, street light, street lamp is there. So when that street lamp will be on at the night only, and when there is a day is there at the morning, the street light becomes automatically off. So how to detect? So it detects the your sunlight, and when there is a sunlight, your street lamp is off. When there is no sunlight, then the street lamp is on. Okay, so that type of the smart lamps you can also design by using the LDR. Okay, so the simulation is done here. If there is no light is there, then no current flow through this resistor because of the high resistance. If there is a light, the resistor becomes low, and there is a current flow is there, because we know that the current is Ohm's law is there. Okay, so it is the V is equal to IR. Okay, so I is equal to V by R. So I is the indirectly proportional to resistance. So current is indirectly proportional to resistor. If the resistance increases, current decreases. If the resistance decreases, current increases. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram that you need to implement here. So first one is LDR is only having two terminals. One of the terminal of your LDR going to the 5 volt. Second terminal is going to the resistor one end, and the same terminal is going to the A0 or to A5. Any of A0 to A5 you can use for its purpose. So analog in you can use here. The resistor that we are going to use here, the 10 kilo ohm. Okay, but you can use 5 kilo ohm. Of 5 to 10 kilo ohm is acceptable here. And another terminal of the resistor is going to the ground terminal. Okay, so this is the diagram, circuit diagram, and the interfacing diagram. Now next is the program. Now program is very again easy. It is very similar to your pot valve. Instead of the pot valve, just we have used the LDR valve. Because it is also the analog sensor, so it will use it is we are using analog read A0, so your LDR is connected to A0. So whatever the value of the A0, it will be put into the LDR valve variable, and we are printing that LDR valve value here itself. The next program is changing LED brightness using LDR. Yeah, the same program you can do. The pot valve program, the same program we can do using the LDR, because we can vary the light intensity. The same LED blinking rate also we can control to the LED. Okay, LED and buzzer control on the analog sensor also we can do. Okay, so if a particular analog sensor is there, and that analog sensor is having threshold value as a 700, then you can say that here the light is detected, otherwise the darkness is detected. Okay, so you can find out this threshold manually. Just throw the light there, or put your hand above your LDR, and then you can find out the threshold for your LDR. So we'll do one simulation here. So yeah, so in the morning session, actually one of you has asked me that what is the simulation software. Okay, so this is a Tinkercad software that I'm going to use for the same thing here, because the same thing you can also copy it at your end. So first, what we need, you need a Uno. Okay, you need a Uno, Arduino Uno. So here I'm putting the Arduino Uno here. Okay, so Arduino Uno I'm getting. The next one is the, what we need? We need a photoresistor. Photoresistor. Okay, so this is my photoresistor. So I'm putting this photo resistor. Now, what we again need? We need a breadboard. Okay, so mini breadboard we are using here. Okay, so this is my mini breadboard. So I'm putting my photo resistor here. Okay, and then what we need? We need a resistor. Okay, so this is the resistor. So one of the terminal of your photoresistor is connected to resistor, and the value of this resistor is 10 kilo ohm. Okay, so 10k resistor I am giving here. Now make the connection. So ground terminal is connected to here, and 5 volt is connected to here. I am changing the just color code of the wire. So it is black for the ground, red for the VCC. Now next one is the middle terminal. Middle terminal is connecting to the A0. So I am putting to the A0. Okay, so done. So connection is done. Now next one is writing code. So just go to the code. Okay, so I'm not going to use block. I'm using the text editor. Okay, so firstly we should start with the serial communication. Serial dot begin 9600. This is all are the simulation. You don't require the actual hardware to run this program. So next one is you want to read the value. So int val is equal to Okay, so this function is analog read function, and A0 is the where I have connected my LDR. Okay, now next one is the I need to put that val value to serial. Okay, so just serial dot print. I'm putting here LDR value is equal to, and on the next line I'm writing here print ln, and the val I'm printing there, and in between the two reading I'm putting the delay of 1000 millisecond. Okay, so my program is done. Now we are just starting the simulation. So my simulation is starting. I'm opening my serial communication, serial monitor. Now you can see here. Okay, so now LDR value is 54. I am changing the light. Okay, so here I am changing the light, and let's see what is the now result. Okay, now it is 949. Okay, just look at here. It is 949. Okay, now if, okay, so if I'm changing again to the darkness, your LDR value will be decreases. Again, LDR value will be decreases. Full dark, it is 54. If it is again increase up to the light, so it is 969. If I'm fully increase, so it is 1023. If it's fully increase, 1023. Okay, so this is a simple simulation of the LDR. You should try at your end also. Just create one account on Tinkercad and do these practicals. The simple practicals actually you can do there. Okay, so it has stopped the simulation. Okay, so are you getting this LDR? Yes. So can I start with the new interfacing, or any doubt? Okay, just type yes. No doubts. Okay, now next interfacing is the IR sensor interfacing. Again, this is a digital sensor. Okay. This is a digital sensor, actually infrared sensor. So this infrared sensor will give the infrared sensor is used for the obstacle detection. So there are the two diodes are there. One is used for the transmission. One is used for the reception. Okay. One used for the transmission, one used for the reception. Okay. So it is having the IR transmitter. So black LED. Black LED is the transmitter and the receiver is the white LED. It is a digital sensor. So it means that it is giving the output of only 0 and 1. So when the obstacle is detected, IR sensor will send digital 0 to Arduino. So if the obstacle is there, if anyone is there in front of that IR, then it will send 0 to Arduino. Otherwise, in the absence of obstacle, it will send 1. So this is the case for my sensor. In the market, actually, there are the different manufacturers are also there. In that manufacturers, and this is my sensor, IR sensor. There are manufacturers where they have designed such that if the obstacle is detected, then IR sensor will send digital 1 to Arduino. Otherwise, it will send digital 0 to Arduino. Okay. So when you purchase the IR, actually, first check that what is the value when there is an obstacle, and then the another value is the there is for a no obstacle. But the drawback of this IR sensor is, can anybody tell me what is the drawback of IR sensor? Okay, can any one of you had tell me what is the drawback of IR sensor? Generally, this drawback is a very, very need LOS. Yeah, line of sight. Yes, it need line of sight. Again, second drawback. It is mentioned. It is range is also the drawback. It is only operates up to the 10 centimeter for that 10 to 20 centimeters only. Now the drawback is mentioned on your slide. Here, if there is a surface, if there is a black surface is there. In case of the black surface, the all the light, IR light that is being transmitted is being absorbed by the black surface and it will not reflect. So it means that if there is an obstacle in front of the IR and if that obstacle is having the color of a black color, then the IR sensor will detect as a no obstacle there. So it is being actually mentioned in your slide. That is, transmitter is sending the light, but the black surface will all capture all the light, all absorb all the light, and it will not reflect. But in case of white surface, it will reflect. So a white surface means other than black surface. Other than black surface, the IR sensor will detect. But for black surface, it will not detect the obstacle. That is the main drawback of the IR. So if you want to fool the IR, just place the black surface in front of IR. Then your IR will not detect any obstacle. Now this is the drawback. This is the diagram, circuit diagram of your IR sensor. Very simple. It is having the three terminal: out terminal, ground terminal, VCC terminal. Very simple connection. VCC connected to VCC, ground connected to ground, and the out terminal is connected to any one of the digital I/O. Any one of digital I/O is connected. So you can connect to pin number 2 or to pin number 3, pin number 4, any pin you can use there. Okay, so program we will see. In a program is very easy, which is very similar like your switch interfacing, because switch also sending switch from the switch we are also getting 0 or 1, from the IR also we are getting 0 or 1. So here simply IR is connected to pin number 2. So define the mode of the pin number 2 as an input. Then serial communication is started 9600. And very simple, in a loop, if digital read IR, that is read the pin number 2. And if it is 0, then print obstacle detected. Otherwise, print obstacle not detected. Very simple. Okay. So just we have to read the status of that IR or the pin number that which you have connected the IR sensor. Read the status. If that status is 0, obstacle detected. If status is 1, obstacle non-detected. This is the case for my sensor. If you have purchased the IR sensor at the shop, then first check that what is the value when there is an obstacle. It might happen that when you detect when there is an obstacle for your IR sensor, it might send one there. Okay, so first check it, do some research, and then after that we will do the program. Okay, so we will start with this programming. I will not go for the simulation. I am doing this program really. So first one is const integer IR is equal to, I am connecting to pin number 2. Then the pin mode and then IR comma pin mode IR comma input and then serial dot begin 9600. Now in a loop function, first we are reading the status. We are reading the IR status. If IR status is equal to analog read, we need to put the digital read. Okay, so because it is a digital sensor, so we must use the digital read. And where is that IR is connected? At the pin number 2. Okay, so digital read. So IR status is having the value 0 or 1. So we are fitting, we are checking that what is the status. If IR status equal to 0, we are just printing here serial dot println obstacle. Detected, else serial dot println, or simply I am not putting else statement because it is continuously sending my obstacle is not detected. Okay, so when there is obstacle is there, it will only print obstacle data. When there is no obstacle, it will not do anything. So just I am using here delay 100. So I'm saving this program as a IR underscore NHCE. And I am uploading this program. So when I upload this program, actually, meanwhile it is being uploading now, it uploading is done and we'll see its connection. Okay, so this is my IR. So I'm putting this IR into the breadboard. Yeah, the first pin is out pin. I'm connecting this wire out pin to pin number 2. The second pin is the middle one is the ground pin. This is the ground pin. I am connecting to ground. One more pin is there. That is, I am using a red wire here for the VCC. Okay, VCC, red wire. Okay, connection is done. You can see here, it is powered up. Okay, IR is also powered up. Now go for the serial monitor. Okay, so if I'm going for serial one, now there is no obstacle, so there is no output. So when there is obstacle, okay, so it will see, it will print obstacle detected. Okay, so it is printing obstacle detected. When there is no obstacle, it will not do anything. When there is obstacle, it will continuously printing obstacle detected. When there is no obstacle, it will not detect anything. Okay, so let me show you that also. If there is a black surface is there, it will not do anything. Okay, so this is the whole black wallet. So I'm putting that black wallet here. Okay, so it will also detect, but actually if there's a fully, there is a some brownish color is there. So that's why it is being reflected. In case of the black surface, actually, in case of black surface, it will not detect anything. I require the whole black surface. If there's a whole black surface there, it will absorb all the IR light and it will not detect the obstacle. That is a drawback of your IR LED, IR sensor. Okay, so are you getting this point? IR sensor, or if any are you getting this point? Just type yes. So any doubt, if you have any doubt, then just keep posting there. Okay, so here obstacle detected, obstacle not detected. LED can be connected. If obstacle detected, LED is glowing. If obstacle is not detected, LED is not glowing. Simple buzzer can be also connected. If obstacle is detected, buzzer is start ringing. Otherwise, but the buzzer is not ringing. Okay, 7-segment interfacing. Actually, this 7-segment interfacing is not required. I'm not going to take this 7-segment interfacing, but this is important for the IoT motion sensor. Okay, so we'll start with the motion sensor. Motion sensor is generally IR sensor, is an infrared sensor, but it detects the motion, human motion. It will detect the heat. It will detect the heat of your human body, and depending on that, if the heat is detected, it will send one to this output pin. This motion sensor is also the digital sensor. So it is through which we can get 0 or 1 only. If the motion is detected, then it will send 1. If the motion is not there, then it will send a 0. Very simple. So passive infrared sensor is a passive infrared sensor, is an electronic sensor that measures the IR light radiating from objects in its field of the view. They are most often used in PIR based motion detector. PIR sensors are commonly used in security alarm and automatic lighting. This type of sensor actually is a very common sensor. They are generally used in your security camera, smoke alarm, when there is a one of the person came there in that room, actually the alarm will be on. So the burglar detector, so security system. So that is the automatic lighting application. This is also one of the great applications in the motion sensor. So PIR sensor detect the general movement, but do not give information on who or what move. Okay. So it will not detect the difference between the human or the other animals. Okay. So if the dog is also there in front of the motion sensor, it will also detect the motion. So it will not give the classification that human is there or the dog or cat is there. So whatever in front of it, if it is moved, then it will sense it and it will send one. So PIR simply refer as a passive infrared sensor, or it is also referred as a PID or passive infrared detector. The term passive refers to the fact that PIR device do not radiate energy for detection purpose. So it do not radiate energy. It absorbs any energy. It absorbs the heat external. That's why it is known as a passive sensor. They work entirely by detecting the infrared radiation emitted by the reflected from the object. So generally, radiation means heat. Okay, so radiate heat emitted by the particular object. If it is a heated object, then it will detect. Okay, so this is the pinout of the IR sensor. So I can show you first the actual motion sensor. This is my actual motion sensor. Okay, so it is having the three pins. It is having three pins. First pin is ground, second is out, and the third is VCC. Ground, out, and VCC. Actually, if you want to see the pin naming convention for this motion sensor, actually, it will not printed at the back side. It will not printed at back side, so you will not get that name of the every pin here at the pin itself. If you want to get the name, so just remove this cap. When you remove this cap, so here you will get the naming. Okay, so here you will get the that naming. So which is ground, which is out, and which is VCC there. Okay, and this is that IR sensor, IR, which will detect the heat. And this is the dome here. The dome will absorb the light from the all direction. So very simple. So ground, out, and VCC, this is the pin number. And now there is a sensitivity control and the delay time control port is there. Two ports are there. So sensitivity means up to 7 centimeter, 7 meter, we can detect the motion there up to 7 meter. But also, if you don't want this up to 7 meter, we can also decrease it by varying that pot. Just decrease the pot, your sensitivity will be decreased. Increase the pot, your sensitivity will be increased there. Delay time means actually when there is a motion is detected, how much time that one will be appear on out pin, that will decide that pot of the delay time. So if you have the delay time as a 1 minute, if you set the delay time as a 1 minute, so it means that at the out pin, one will be available for 1 minute only. So maximum you can set the timing for 5 minutes. So it means that when the motion is detected at the out pin, up to 5 minutes, there is a one is available. Okay, so after the 5 minute is over, again it will check that motion is detected or not. If it is not detected, then it will out pin is low. If it is again detected, the out pin is high there. Now there is again one jumper is there, that is for the selecting its action for the this motion sensor. One is for repeatable trigger and second is for non-repeatable trigger. Now repeatable trigger means once the motion is detected, the out pin is having the one. And after the delay time over, it will again check the motion. If again motion is detected, continuously out pin is having the one there until the motion is there. When there is a motion, out pin is one. But in a non-repeatable trigger, it is not the case. In the non-repeatable trigger, what happened? When motion is detected, it will out is one for delay time. After the delay time, the out has to be make it as a zero. Though that there is a motion or not, has to make it as a zero there. Again, after some time, again it will detect the motion. Again, the out becomes one. So it means that here in a non-repeatable trigger, if at the out terminal, suppose one LED is connected in a non-repeatable trigger, the LED has to be off after some delay time. But in a repeatable trigger, actually LED is continuously on. LED will be continuously on if there is a motion happened in front of that motion. So generally I'm using always the repeatable trigger mode. So until I'm in front of my motion sensor, my light should be on. When I move from that motion sensor, after the delay time over, your light should be off there. Okay. So use the repeatable trigger for your case. But in some cases, actually, you have to on the light only one time when the motion is detected. At that time, you must use the non-repeatable trigger. Okay. So this is the working there. This is the use of the dome that is placed there, plastic dome. It will absorb the heat from all the direction and it will concentrate all this heat to the center. And that IR will, the inner IR will receive all the energy. So it will make more accurately result. Okay, so it is a passive infrared sensor. So this is the one of the video.
Hello, then. In this tutorial, hello, Dan Nedelkovsky here from howtomechatronics.com. In this tutorial, we will learn how to use a PIR sensor for detecting motion. First, let's explain the working principle. The module actually consists of a pyroelectric sensor which generates energy when exposed to heat. That means when a human or animal body will get in the range of the sensor, it will detect a movement because the human or the animal body emits heat energy in a form of infrared radiation. That's where the name of the sensor comes from, a passive infrared sensor. And the term passive means that the sensor is not using any energy for detecting purposes. It just works by detecting the energy given off by the other objects. The module also consists of a specially designed cover named Frenzel lens, which focuses the infrared signals onto the pyroelectric sensor. Okay, now let's connect the module to the Arduino board. The module has three pins, a ground and a VCC for powering the module, and an output pin which gives high logic level if an object is detected. Also, it has two potentiometers, one for adjusting the sensitivity of the sensor and the other for adjusting the time the output signal stays high when the object is detected. This time can be adjusted from 0.3 seconds up to 5 minutes. The module has three more pins with a jumper between two of them. These pins are for selecting the trigger modes. The first one is called non-repeatable trigger and works like this. When the sensor output is high and the delay time is over, the output will automatically change from high to low level. The other mode, called repeatable trigger, will keep the output high all the time until the detected object is present in the sensor's range. As an example for this tutorial, I will make a circuit that will turn on a high voltage lamp when the sensor will detect an object. Here is the circuit schematic. The output pin of the sensor will be connected to the pin number 8 on the Arduino board, and when an object will be detected, the pin number 7 will activate the relay module and the high voltage lamp will turn on. For more details how the relay module works, you can check my Arduino relay tutorial. Here's the Arduino code for this example. It's quite simple, we just need to define the PIR sensor pin as input and the relay pin as output. Using the digital read function, we will read the output of the sensor, and if it's high or if an object is detected, it will activate the relay. For activating the relay module, we will send a logic low as the relay input pin works inversely. Here's the demonstration of the example. Note that after powering the sensor module, it needs about 20 to 60 seconds to warm up in order to function properly. Now, when I will put my hand in front of the sensor, the relay will activate the lamp. But note that even if I move my hand constantly, the lamp will turn off after the adjusted delay time is over because the PIR sensor is in non-repeatable trigger mode. If I change the sensor with the jumper to the repeatable trigger mode and I constantly move the hand, the lamp will be constantly on as well and it will turn off after the movement is gone and the set delay time is over. Thanks for watching, and for more tutorials, visit my official website howtomechatronics.com.
Okay, so this is the working of the that and the same project actually they have explained in this video. Okay, so this is the circuit diagram where we can use this motion sensor. Simply VCC connected to VCC, ground connected to ground, and this middle terminal, that is out terminal, is connected to any one of digital IO. So here it is connected to pin number 2, and again there is a buzzer is also connected to indicate that the motion is detected or not. If the motion is detected, the buzzer will be glow. Otherwise, the buzzer will not glow. Okay, so this is the program. In that program, program is again very easy. So very simple. PIR is the digital sensor, digital input sensor. So that's why PIR pin, that is pin number 2, should be declared as an input, and then we will read the that pin number 2 by using digital read function. That is going to PIR status variable. PIR status variable can have the value of 0 and 1 only. Now we will checking that it is, what is the value. It is, if it is 1, then obstacle is detected. Otherwise, it will print the obstacle is not detected. Okay, so again, this for the one buzzer. Buzzer is again one buzzer is connected. If the obstacle is detected, then the buzzer will ringing. Otherwise, the buzzer A will be off there. Okay, very simple program is there. And this is the assignment. Now next is the, we will see the simulation of, we'll see the simulation of this motion sensor, and we'll try to run this program. Okay, so I'm doing, okay, so I'm removing these wires and the all these components, and let me check here the motion sensor is there or not. Okay, yes, motion sensor is there. So I am giving this motion sensor, I am putting here. Okay, so this is my motion sensor. The first is signal, second is power, and third is ground. So power means 5 volt. So I'm putting this 5 volt power supply here. It is, I'm making as a red. The second one is the ground. Just check it here, ground, yes, it is ground. Yeah, it is ground, and make it as a black. And the next one is the pin number 2. To pin number 2, I am connecting. Pin number 2, I have connected, and it leave it as a green. Okay, and now it is time for coding. Okay, so in a coding, actually, serial dot begin, yeah, we require serial dot begin, and then first one is pin mode, we require pin mode, then pin number 2 to comma input. Okay, so So I'm not using that variable here. So first read the use the digital read function, digital read two, and that variable I'm using int st, or the simply motion is equal to, okay, and check that motion status. If motion equal to one, if motion equal to one, then serial dot println motion is detected. Okay, else serial dot println motion not detected. Okay, so very simple program I have done. Now we'll start with the simulation. Start with the simulation and let's see, is it correct or not? Okay, motion not detected. How to change the motion actually? I don't know here. Because for the simulation actually, here's for simulation, there should be for the simulation, if there is, I can change here the value here, then I can show you. Okay, so actually here I am not able to change the its motion. It is only the component, but its motion detected or not detected, this status is not given in this simulation. Okay, but the same thing if we have implement in our case in your hardware actually, what happened when you place the hand in front of that motion sensor, it will see the send output as a motion is detected. But how much time that it send output, it depending on the that pot value that you have set here. So do not change the pot value when you purchase the new one, because it is already calibrated. So if you are using that motion sensor in your project and if you want the different delay time, then only change that pot value. And again, make sure that that particular that jumper should be in your repeatable trigger mode. It should not be in a not repeatable trigger mode. If you want to continuously detect the motion, then it should be in a repeatable trigger mode. Okay, so this is the program actually for the motion sensor. Very simple thing, just read the motion status. If the motion status is one, then what to do, you have to write here, otherwise you have to write in an else block. So I'm stopping the simulation here because I'm not able to change here the status of my motion layer. Okay, so let it be. So this is the assignment actually. Write a program to interface motion sensor, buzzer and the LED. Yeah, buzzer also integrate, LED also integrate to detect the human motion event. In case of motion, switch on the buzzer and LED. Okay, so you have to on the buzzer and LED, otherwise it remains off. Okay, so this is the motion sensor. Now next sensor is the ultrasonic sensor. Okay, so any doubt in motion sensor, first let me clear your all the doubts in the motion sensor, then we will start with the next sensor. So any doubt in motion sensor, very simple sensor is there, digital sensor is there. It is having the output of 0 and 1 only. If sensor is if the motion is detected, it will send the 1. If the motion is not detected, it will send 0. Very simple. So any doubt? Okay, if you have no doubt, just type no doubt in the chat box. Then I can move forward. just type no doubts, or otherwise if you have any doubt, then just type your doubts on your chat window. Okay, no doubts. Okay, so let's see the next sensor interfacing, and that is the ultrasonic sensor. So ultrasonic sensor is again very, very famous sensor for sensing the distance. Okay, so distance measurement sensor, it is another name to the ultrasonic sensor. So there it is HC-SR04, ultrasonic sensor, HC-SR04 is the name. It is having four pins. First is VCC, second one is trigger pin, third is the eco pin, and the fourth one is the ground pin. Now you must understand this working of the trigger pin, working of the ultrasonic sensor. What is the meaning of the trigger and echo? You should first understand this thing, then only you can do the programming of this ultrasonic sensor. VCC ground is very easy. Connect VCC to 5 volt, ground to ground. Now where to connect trigger and echo? Okay, let me see. Trigger has to configure as an output pin on Arduino. Okay, so trigger has to set as output pin. So it is the output pin for the Arduino, but the input pin for your, it is an input pin for your ultrasonic sensor. Because ultrasonic sensor is also having its own microcontroller present at the backside. Okay, so you can see the that crystal oscillator is present there, 4 megahertz crystal oscillator. So it is having its own microcontroller. To that microcontroller, trigger is the input pin. But to give the trigger input pin, your Arduino, where that trigger pin is connected, that trigger pin should be configured as output pin. And the echo pin should be configured as input pin. Okay, so echo is connected to Arduino, but where you have connected that echo pin, it should be configured as input because it is an output from your ultrasonic sensor. Okay, so from your ultrasonic sensor, echo pin will make a 0 or will make a 1, but the trigger is the input pin. Now what is the working of trigger and echo, we'll see, but before that we will see the features of HC-SR04. Okay, so it is operating voltage is plus 5 volt. Its theoretical measuring distance is 2 centimeter to 450 centimeter, but I can guarantee up to only 200 centimeter only, because I have tested here. Practical measuring distance is 2 centimeter to 80 centimeter, but you can measure up to the 200 centimeter also. Accuracy is 3 millimeter is the accuracy. Measuring angle covered is less than 15 degree. Operating current is very, very less, that is less than 15 milliampere. And the operating frequency is the 40 hertz. Now print description, as we know that VCC ground, we already have discussed. Now next one is trigger. Trigger pin is an input pin. Input pin to ultrasonic sensor. This pin has to be kept high for 10 microseconds to initialize the measurement by sending the ultrasonic wave. So it means that if you want to start the measurement, then the trigger on the trigger pin, you have to send the one pulse of 10 microsecond. So trigger is on for only 10 microsecond, then trigger is low. So one pulse has to be sent. One pulse only, the width of that pulse should be the 10 microsecond. So make the trigger low, then make the trigger high, wait for 10 microsecond, again make the trigger low there. So it make your trigger as a to send a 10 microsecond pulse. Okay, so this is the input to your ultrasonic sensor, but the output from your Arduino. Next one is your echo pin. Echo pin is an output pin. Now what happened when there is a trigger is activated? That when the trigger is activated, the ultrasonic wave is transmitted by your ultrasonic sensor. The ultrasonic wave is through in front of it. So it is being traveling, but when obstacle is detected, what happened with that ultrasonic wave? It is reflected back. So when it is reflected back, echo pin will go high, for which it takes time for returning back to the sensor. So echo pin is one, but how much time it is one? The time by which the transmission started and the time at which after you receive the that reflected wave. So if the transmitted time is t1 and the receiving time is t2, the echo will be 1 for t2 minus t1. The echo will be 1 for the t2 minus t1. So this pin goes high for a period of time which is equal to the time taken for the ultrasonic wave to return back to the sensor. So by measuring the width of the echo, actually you can get the time which is required to travel that ultrasonic sensor. Okay, and by using that time, you can easily get the distance because we know the speed of the ultrasonic sensor. Okay, so this is the working. So as shown in the above, the HCSR ultrasonic sensor is a 4-pin module, which pin name are the VCC, trigger, ground, respectively. This sensor is a very popular sensor used in many applications where measuring distance or sensing object is required. The module has two eyes like a project in front of which form the ultrasonic transmitter and receiver. The sensor work with the simple high school formula, that is distance is equal to speed into time. Now time we can get by using that echo pin. Okay, if you know the speed of the ultrasonic sensor, ultrasonic wave, then that speed multiply by the time, you will get a distance. The ultrasonic transmitter transmit an ultrasonic wave. This wave travel in the air, and when it is objected by any material, it get reflected back toward the sensor. This is a reflected wave is observed by the ultrasonic receiver module as shown in the figure. Okay, so you can see that diagram. Where the, when the object is detected, your ultrasonic wave is reflected back. So now to calculate the distance using the above formula, we should know the speed and time. So since we are using the ultrasonic wave, we know that the universal speed of US wave at the room temperature is the 330 meter per second. Okay, so you can Google it also, the speed of ultrasonic wave. The circuitry inbuilt on the module will calculate the time taken for the ultrasonic wave to come back and turns on the echo pin high for that particular amount of time. This way, we can also know the time taken. So it means that by reading the echo, how much time that echo is high, just calculate that time, we know that speed, and by using that speed and time, you can get the distance there. Okay. So this is the simple connection. VCC connected to VCC, ground connected to ground. Trigger is connected to one of the pin, 11. So here 11 should be configured as output pin, and echo is connected to 12. So 12 should be connected to as a 12 should be configured as a input pin. Okay. So this is the program. Declare the trigger pin as a 11, echo pin as a 12. Now duration, actually duration is where duration means time. So time we are getting in terms of the millisecond or microsecond. So that's why the I'm not taking as an integer, I'm taking as a long variable. So if it is a long variable, actually it can hold the that floating value also. So int distance, and then pin void, pin void setup, pin mode trigger pin comma output, echo pin comma input. So as I said earlier, trigger pin should be configured as output, echo pin should be configured as a input. Serial communication has been begin with 9600. Now what is the first thing on the trigger pin to initiate the measurement? We must send the 10 microsecond pulse to trigger pin. So how to send 10 microseconds? So very first one is make the trigger low for the 2 microseconds. Okay, so this 2 microseconds is not constant, it can be anything, it is just taken, you can taken as a 5, 10, 50, anything. So trigger pin is low, then after 2 microseconds, digital write trigger pin comma low, trigger pin comma high, so trigger pin becomes high. Now delay microsecond 10, so up to 10 microsecond it is high, then after 10 microsecond get over, your trigger pin becomes low, trigger pin becomes low. So it means that here the width of this the width of this pulse is 10 microsecond, and when the trigger pin is having the 10 microsecond pulse, your ultrasonic sensor will receive that pulse. Upon receiving that pulse, actually your ultrasonic wave is transmitting. Now you are waiting for the echo pin. Now to wait for the echo pin, actually we are using the pulse in function. Now there is an inbuilt function for the Arduino, pulse in function, which is reading the echo pin, how much time that echo pin is high. Okay, so the definition is very simple: pulse in, echo pin comma high. So it means that measure the time that how much time this echo pin is high, measure the time by which this echo pin is high, pulse in. Okay, you can also measure with the low, just make it as a low, but we are dealing with the high here. We want the time by which your echo pin is high there. So that duration you are getting here, the duration you are getting, now multiply by that duration with the speed. Now here speed is converted into the centimeter per second, because 330 meter per second is the given here, but here it is taken as 343 meter per second. At 27 degree Celsius, it is 343 meter per second. So here it is converted from meter to second. So meter to centimeter. So 343 meter per second is converted into the centimeter per second, it becomes 0.0343 centimeter per second. So it is the speed, duration multiply by the speed divided by 2 is given. Can anybody tell me why it is divided by 2? Out of all 27 participants, can anybody tell me why it is divided by 2? This is the very good question. Why it is divided by 2? Why not direct? Because in a formula, actually we are directly taken. Duration or the time taken multiplied by the speed is distance. But it is divided by 2 and fro. Yes, Akash, it is very correct. Because time that we are considering, that is the to and fro time. The time travel by the wave is the to and fro. So that's why the distance is always to and fro. But we want the one-way distance only. We want one-way distance. So to get the one-way distance, actually we are dividing by 2. So very good, Akash. Then serial.print distance. Yes, the distance is printed in a centimeter and we are waiting for 2 seconds. And you will get your output in a 2 seconds itself. Okay, so when you actually object, when your obstacle is moving away, your distance is also becomes more. When the obstacle is less, your distance is less. Very simple. So this is the output actually. You will get output like this. Here one if statement is only added. If the distance is less than or equal to 5, then obstacle is present. Otherwise, obstacle is not present. So you can also do the if else statement. Okay, so here one video is there. Just last video we'll see. Very interesting video. So this is the again one of the application of your ultrasonic sensor. And recently in your area also this using the ultrasonic sensor actually this new product has been come in the market, automatic sanitizer dispenser.
नमस्कार दोस्तों, फ्लिप्टन ऑटोमेशन सॉल्यूशंस पेश करता है इंडिया का मोस्ट अफोर्डेबल टचलेस ऑटोमेटिक हैंड सैनिटाइजर डिस्पेंसर। सबसे पहले हम बताना चाहेंगे कि इस प्रोडक्ट
Look at here. Here the that ultrasonic sensor is placed here. So it will detect the hand, that is the distance. Actually, it is not detect hand, it will detect the distance. If the distance is suppose less than 5 centimeter, then it will start the pump, and through that pump actually you will get this your sanitizer.
Product ko puri tarah se India mein design and manufacture kiya gaya hai. कोरोना वायरस के चलते क्रॉस इन्फेक्शन से बचने के लिए हो सके उतना एक्सपोज सरफेस को टच करने से बचना चाहिए। इस डिस्पेंसर को ऑपरेट करने के लिए सिर्फ इसके नीचे हाथ ले जाइए और इसका सेंसर इस तरीके से प्रोग्राम किया गया है कि वो प्रिसाइजली 2 से 3 ml सैनिटाइजर ऑटोमेटिक डिस्पैच करेगा ताकि ज्यादा सैनिटाइजर वेस्ट ना हो। इसके बॉक्स के अंदर आपको एक हैंड सैनिटाइजर डिस्पेंसर यूनिट, उसके साथ वॉल माउंटिंग के लिए स्क्रू जाएगा, यानी कि एक मिड साइज फैमिली को यानी कि वो डिस्पैच हो रहा है। और ये जो पूरा प्रोडक्ट है वो मेड इन इंडिया प्रोडक्ट है और इसको बनाने के लिए एक्सपोर्ट क्वालिटी की वुड शीट का इस्तेमाल किया गया है। ये काफी स्ट्रॉन्ग है, अगर हाइट से आप गिरा दें, उसके ऊपर आप चढ़ जाएं, तो भी इसको कुछ होने वाला नहीं है। ये एटलीस्ट 5 से 10 साल तक चलता रहेगा। इसके अंदर जो सर्किट है उसके ऊपर 6 मंथ की वारंटी भी है। इसे आप फैक्ट्रीज, ऑफिस, शॉप, घर, स्कूल्स और कॉलेजेस में इस्तेमाल कर सकते हैं और हार्मफुल बैक्टीरिया एंड वायरसेस से बच सकते हैं। तो अगर आपको इसको परचेज करना है तो www.flipton.com पर जाकर।
सो दिस काइंड ऑफ एक्चुअली एप्लीकेशन यू कैन इजीली डू विद दिस अल्ट्रासोनिक सेंसर। ओके, सो फॉर यू मस्ट नो दी that basic working of these sensors. If you know the basic working, then you can easily do the stuffs. Okay, so I think LCD is not required, DST. So DST, I will take it as a, I'm not taking today. Tomorrow at the start, I am taking the DST interfacing because it is a somewhat long one. Any doubt, we will take the doubt clearing session from this. What is the minimum surface area ultrasonic sensor detect? Minimum surface area. So actually that surface area is depends on the position of your ultrasonic sensor where you have mounted. So if you mounted accordingly, actually you can get the more surface area. Okay. Any other doubts? Yes, yeah, here the Rajesh sir has given the afternoon feedback link. You just need to click that feedback link and go there. Just fill the feedback. The same feedback will be treated as your attendance. Yes, any other doubts? Okay, no. So tomorrow we'll start with the we'll start with the Node MCU. Actually, Node MCU is very similar like your Arduino Uno, but the main difference is the Node MCU is having the inbuilt Wi-Fi in it. ESP8266 is there. Okay, so using that ESP8266, we can communicate to the internet. Okay, if you are communicating with using the internet, then we can send our data on a platform, our cloud platform. Okay, the cloud platform can be our or rented cloud platform. Yeah, it is posted. Okay. Sorry. Rajesh sir, actually you have sent me privately. Keep it to everyone. So this is the link, afternoon feedback link. Afternoon feedback link. Okay, so regarding the recording, actually, the all the recording sessions of this sessions will be available only after completing the whole HTTP. So nowadays, only two session is available, first two session, but to today's morning and afternoon and the day tomorrow's and all the remaining days, actually the recording will be available after completing the HTTP. Okay, so if you don't have any doubts, then actually then we can complete the session. Just make sure that you have filled that feedback link. Yes, thank you.